You need to maximize the area of a corral for your pet. However, there is a cliff on one side, so you only need to fence three sides of the corral. So if this is the corral, let's assume this red dashed line here would be the cliff, so you don't have to fence this side of the rectangle. If you have 1,200 yards of fencing available, what are the dimensions of the rectangle with the maximum area, and what is the maximum area? Because we don't know the length of the sides of the rectangle, let's go ahead and call this side length x. And because the opposite sides of a rectangle have equal length, this would also be x. And now because we have a total of 1,200 yards of fencing, the length of this side here would have to be the total length minus x, or 1,200 minus 2x. Again, this length here is a total amount of fencing minus the lengths of the two sides here, which is represented by minus 2x. And now because the area of a rectangle is equal to length times width, we can say the area of this rectangle would be A equals x times the quantity 1,200 minus 2x. Let's go ahead and distribute here. That would give us A equals 1,200x minus 2x squared. Notice how we have a quadratic function here. So let's write this as a function. We'll say A is a function of x, or A of x equals. Now let's put the terms in descending order. So we have negative 2x squared plus 1,200x. And now that our quadratic is in this form here, we should be able to recognize that the coefficient of x squared, or A, is equal to negative 2. B, the coefficient of x, is equal to 1,200. And because there's no constant term, that means C would be equal to 0. So because we have a quadratic function and A is equal to negative 2, or A is negative, we should recognize that the graph of this quadratic would open downward like this. And therefore, the x-coordinate of this vertex here would actually give us the length of this side of the rectangle that would maximize the area, and the y-coordinate of the vertex would be that maximum area. So let's go ahead and take this function here onto the next slide and find the coordinates of the vertex. Remember, when our quadratic function is in this form here, the x-coordinate of the vertex is negative b divided by 2a, and the y-coordinate, or the function value, would be f of negative b divided by 2a. So once we find the x-coordinate of the vertex, we'll then sub that value into our function to find the y-coordinate of the vertex. So again, we already know that a is equal to negative 2, and b is equal to 1,200. And again, our goal here is to find the coordinates of the vertex. We'll begin by finding the x-coordinate of the vertex. So we'll let x equal negative b divided by 2a, where b is 1,200. So we have negative 1,200 divided by 2 times a, which is negative 2. So this would give us negative 1,200 divided by negative 4, which is equal to 300. So the x-coordinate of the vertex is 300. So if we go back to our sketch just for a moment, that means the length of this side would have to be 300 yards in order to maximize the area of this rectangle. Now that we know x is 300, we can actually find the length of this side by subbing 300 for x. If x is 300, we would have 1,200 minus 2 times 300, which is 600. 1,200 minus 600 is 600. So this length here would have to be 600 yards. But we're also asked to find the maximum area, which would just be the product of 300 and 600. But if we go back to our work just for a moment, now that we have x equals 300, we could also find the area by finding the y-coordinate, or the function value, of our function a of x. Let's just show that we would get the same value. A of 300 would be equal to negative 2 times 300 squared plus 1,200 times 300. So this would be 300 squared, which is 90,000 times negative 2, negative 180,000 plus 1,200 times 300 would be 360,000, which is equal to 180,000. And again, just to compare, using the rectangle, we know the area would just be 300 times 600 square yards. And of course, 300 times 600 is 180,000. Again, this would be square yards. So just to summarize, the dimensions that maximize the area would be 300 yards by 600 yards. And the maximum area is 180,000 square yards. Let's go ahead and verify these results graphically by graphing our function a of x. To save time, I've already done that. Here it is. We can either graph it in factored form or expanded form, but notice how the vertex here does have an x-coordinate of 300, which represents the width that would maximize the area, and then the y-coordinate, 180,000, represents the maximum area. So this does verify our results. Of course, if we wanted to, we could have also solved this using a graphing calculator. So let's go ahead and quickly show that. So we'll press y equals, clear any old functions, and type in our new function, either in factored form or expanded form. I'm going to type in 1,200x minus 2x squared. And we do have to change the window. To save time, I've already adjusted the window. Notice how the x values go from negative 100 to 700. The y values go from negative 10,000 to 200,000. And now if we press graph, we can use the calculation feature to determine the vertex. We can press second, trace for calculation, and then we want option 4 for maximum. So we'll press 4. Left bound means move the cursor to the left side of the vertex. Somewhere here, press enter, move to the right of the vertex, somewhere here, press enter, and enter one more time. Notice how the calculator is not perfect. We need to recognize that this does represent an x value of 300 and the y value is 180,000. I hope you found this explanation helpful.